Hi, I'm Alvin Drew. I'm an astronaut. This is Ask NASA, and I'm here to answer your questions. So who is going to the moon with NASA? It's going to be a lot of folks. It's going to be our own industry helping us get there. It's all going to be our international partners, many of whom have been with us on the International Space Station, plus a few others. Who's building the gateway? Well, for those of you not familiar, this is the gateway. Lots of folks are going to build this. Different companies are going to build these things. Different countries are going to contribute. This part here with the legs on it is the part that takes off and lands from the surface of the moon. And then finally, this is a transition stage to get us across that 50,000 mile gap between the gateway and the moon. The gateway is a great place for us to stay on the moon. And so if you have a vehicle out there that can dock to it, no matter what it is, no matter what country you're from, you can plug into it. You can get power, you can get data, and then you become part of the gateway. The gateway will work a lot like the International Space Station. We'll assemble it using robotic arms and spacewalks as well, along with docking and berthing, just like we do today. Why does NASA need partners? Well, it's because we're doing great things out there. We're not going to go anywhere without our partners with us. It's going to take a crew to get us to Mars. Another example of our international partnership is the International Space Station. 19 nations in total is what it took to make that space station is what it is today. So what's the next question here? Is this a modern space race? Well, yes and no. Yes, we're up against the clock, but no, we're not racing against each other. This is more of a partnership, a relay race that involves our domestic industry as well as our international partners. So how did going into space influence you? It's a tiny, tiny little island in the middle of a great big black sea. There's no little yellow boundary line separating our countries from one another. We really are all together here on this one island in the middle of nowhere.
That was the best throw we've ever had, I think. So what does it feel like in space?
You're weightless, you unstrap from your seat, and you can float. Imagine being in a pool without any water. You're not wet. What's the best way to become an astronaut? I can tell you the one thing every astronaut had in common is that they were pursuing something that was not being an astronaut, that really had their passion. They really liked what they were doing, and that's why they excelled at it, and that's why they stood out enough to become an astronaut.
Where can you find the best views on the International Space Station?
From the cupola, far and away, the best investment we've ever made. You can just see the universe from there, short of going out on a spacewalk.
I heard you were in a Willie Nelson video. Do you still have your costume?
Of course I still have my costume. What else do you think I'm wearing when I'm playing air guitar? One of the cool things about being an astronaut is you can sometimes inadvertently wind up on the set of a video shoot. This one involved Willie Nelson and his Whiskey River Ranch. Well, Alex, I can only guess. We're going to go to Mars here in the near future. We're going to go to the moon in preparation for going to Mars. And by the time we get there, you'll be old enough to come back and tell me what life was like on Mars. To the top, where there's the best view.
Do you have a question for NASA? Send your questions to our experts on Twitter using hashtag AskNASA.